We have to talk Tesla. We haven't yet, but we have to, because take a look at this. The stock is rocketing higher, up about 10% after posting a huge beat on earnings and revenue last quarter. Elon Musk and company also predicting deliveries are on track to exceed 500,000 cars this year. Senior columnist Rick Newman joining us now. So all the naysayers, Rick, all the people who said Elon Musk is he's crazy and it's never going to happen. I guess he can say I told you so.
They're in retreat for sure. I'm sure there are some short sellers getting roasted here. What I think is happening with Tesla is it actually seems to be turning the corner. So if we get a couple more quarters like this where they had two profitable quarters in a row. They're not profitable for the year yet. They've never had a profitable year. But the trend is good. And if they can string together a few more profitable quarters and actually be profitable in 2020 for the year, I think we might be able to say the high wire portion of this company's history is safely in the past, and they get to more. They seem to be getting to more stable production. They're able to hit their targets more predictably. I don't think we're there yet. I think it's premature to say that, but we're getting there. So string together a couple more quarters like this, and I think the future looks good.
Yeah, they're starting to resemble a real profitable
company.
That's right. Not just an auto company, a real
resemble.
Company.
They're not profitable yet. Let's keep that in mind on an annual basis.
And Musk mentioned that they are self-funding, or they could be self-funding. How important is that?
Well, the cash flow is looking a lot better, and I mean, you know, 12 or 18 months ago, there were concerns about whether Tesla was even going to make it financially, and they have gotten through that major rough patch. So now we're looking ahead to the future. So let's, you know, this surge in the stock this morning puts the company's valuation at $115 billion. I mean, that's
insane.
Like three times Ford and General Motors. I give credit to Tesla for what it's accomplished, but I think this valuation is insane. So just a little bit of context here. So Tesla's global market share is less than 0.5%, and it's worth more than Volkswagen at this point, which has more than 10% of global market share. It's almost worth as much as Toyota, also has more than 10% of global market share. So this valuation seems to be based on the idea that Tesla is going to compete with the biggest players in the business on scale at some point within the, you know, medium future.
And we'll have mobile
taxis. I think that's a major stretch.
Yeah.
And, you know, part of what's happening, we've got GM and Ford are going to come out with electric pickups and electric SUVs within the next year or two. We're going to see a flood of new electric vehicles onto the market. So Tesla has had first mover advantage here. They really don't have that anymore.
Before we let you go, their Shanghai factory has closed because of the coronavirus, but they're not the only automaker hit. A lot of automakers could be feeling some pain because of this, right?
Oh, sure, because China is such a big market for autos, and it's much bigger than it was during the SARS virus, what was that, 15 years ago at this point. It's probably a little bit more important for Tesla than it is for the other automakers, because that's the only other factory Tesla has that's actually in operation right now. They're building one in Germany, but that's not online yet. So it really did need to get the China factory up and running for sales in China. So I think Tesla's more exposed to a slowdown or a shutdown there than other automakers, just because it's half of its total factory footprint in the world.
What a remarkable turnaround for Elon Musk here. Rick Newman, thank you.
Hey, investors. Zach Guzman here. Are you interested in learning more about the markets and getting the latest financial news? Well, then click right here to subscribe to our Yahoo Finance YouTube channel. Get the latest up-to-the-minute market analysis, big interviews in the world of finance, and information on how to manage your money every day, wherever you are.